Hey guys, it's Kara from iStampin.com. Thanks for joining me today. Today we are going to be making this fun box to house greeting cards. And there's a card inside that we're going to be making. And I wasn't thinking about it when I put this together because I can't show you. Obviously, you'll see me make it. And so you'll know what it looks like on the inside. But it's a really cute card. Anyway, I am using some retiring products and they are still available. So I wanted to make sure that they are available for you to use. So I will tell you what those items are as we make them. So we're going to make the box first, and as you can see, it has two colors. It's super easy. I found this on Pinterest. This template is really common, so you know, you can find a lot of different templates like that on Pinterest. So let's get started. The first thing that you are going to do is get a piece of crumb cake cardstock, and this is going to measure 9 3/4 by 8 1/2. All right, then the other card stock that you are going to want to get is our Knight of Navy card stock, and this is going to measure 7 7/8 by 6 5/8. So the next thing that we want to do is to get our scoring tool. This is a really easy box to make because for the bottom, the score marks are all the same. So you are going to score it at 2 inches on all four sides. Okay, let's put that off to the side and go ahead and grab your Knight of Navy cardstock. And again, this is going to be the same as the top, but we're going to actually score it at 1 inch. So it's going to be 1 inch on all four sides. So that's what I meant by saying that this is a really easy box to put together, because it's not, you're not having to think of different score marks for the sides and the top. So let's go ahead and fold on all of our score lines and use your bone folder when you are creating boxes and things like that. Having a bone folder is really important. And if you happen to hear a cat meowing, that is Pippa. The door is shut right now because she is insistent on going outside. And she brought a snake inside, so I'm not too crazy about putting her back outside. It was a little baby snake. I don't know what kind of snake it was, but if there's a baby snake, that means there's a mama somewhere nearby. So no thank you. That's what happens when you live in Florida. You get used to these things that I never thought I'd get used to. I'm not used to snakes, but so we're not having any more snakes. All right, the next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna cut on all four of the score lines. This is really similar to other boxes I've made where this will build the wall. So you'll just do this on all four sides. I used our Tombow Mono liquid glue to put the box together. And then here you're going to do the same thing, so we're just going to cut. And I really liked using that. It set up fast, so I think I'm going to use that again. You could use Fast Fuse or Tear and Tape. The liquid glue is really easy. So what I like to do is just fold the flaps down, and then I'm just going to put some glue here. The only thing about is if you get it on the on your grid paper, it's a little sticky, so just be careful with that. I can hear her in the background. It's so funny. She's just waiting for somebody to let her out. So just hold it. If it oozes out, I like just to have a baby wipe close by and just clean off my fingers. And this glue does dry clear. So when you do this, just make sure that you're meeting the edges and that the bottom part is going all the way down to this part of the lid. So this is the top of the lid. And this box, it's 2 inches high, so you should be able to fit quite a few greeting cards in there. I'm thinking, obviously a stack that's 2 inches tall, so I'm not sure how many greeting cards that may be. But the idea was, and you'll see it when I make the card, is I made a matching envelope. And the idea is that, for like teacher appreciation, that's actually next week at my son's school. So I'm thinking of giving this to his teacher and the assistant that's in his classroom. So there's the lid. See how easy that is to use the glue? I think really simple. All right, so the same thing. I just like to fold in those flaps, and let's go ahead and put glue here. And I like how the box is two different colors. It gives it a little bit of interest. And then we will embellish it with the Affectionately Yours Designer Series paper. That is retiring. We're gonna be using quite a few products from that product suite. And so everything's retiring from Affectionately Yours. And but like I said, it's still available. And the colors are great. They're really springy, summery, with the Watermelon Wonder and the Crushed Cucumber Crush. So, which those colors are retiring. Okay. And just one last side. And so we'll just leave this to the side to let it set up. So there you go. So you can see that it's makes a really nice size box. Let me put the lid on there. So there you go. I didn't fold this one all the way. Okay, guys, my battery on my video camera just died, so I'm not quite sure where I left off, but there is the box. I think I was indicating that you can fill this box up quite a bit, but what we're gonna do is go ahead and decorate the top. What I've done here is just cut a piece of designer series paper. This is from the same collection, and this measures 5.5 by 4.25, and I'm just going to adhere this to the top. And then we will finish off decorating the card after we make the card. Let me try that again. We will finish off decorating the box after we create the card, because I want to be able to show you how you can put the card in the box. So you can see the embossed copper foil on that. It's just so pretty. So let's go ahead and make the card. So what you are going to do is just need a piece of crumb cake cardstock. This measures 5.5 by 4.25, and let's go ahead and, no, excuse me, how about, let me try this again, 8.5 by 5.5, and we're gonna score it at 4.25. I'm getting myself mixed up. All right, so got our Simply Scored scoring tool. I'm just gonna score it right there at 4.25. And I'll use my bone folder to burnish that. The next thing I have done is cut a piece of mint macaron cardstock. And this is just 1/4 inch smaller. So this measures 5.25 by 4. Just messing up all around today. And let's just put that on top of the card base. All right, this strip of the designer series paper is 2 inches by 4.25. And I'm just gonna put it right about there. I wanna leave just about 1/4 inch of the mint macaron showing on the left side. All there. Now what I've done is I have cut a piece of Whisper White cardstock. This measures 4 by 3, and this is actually thick Whisper White cardstock, so you can do whichever you choose. I just had quite a bit of scrap, so I just grabbed that. And we are gonna do some embossing. And I'm gonna be using one of the Floral Affections embossing folders. This is a little duo set, and so what I wanna do, and these are retiring as well, so like I said, I checked before starting this video and everything is still available, so you'll be good to go if you just head on over to my online store and make those purchases of whatever you're wanting to get from this project. So what I'm going to do is, as you can see here, that I've kind of angled this embossing folder because I want the impression just to be on the left-hand side. So let me grab my Big Shot. All right, and when using embossing folders, you just need to grab your Big Shot platform. I'm just going to place it right there and just run that through. Super easy. And so that's what it looks like when we're all done. You can see that. And then what I'm going to do next is grab my ink colors. So you're going to need these three inks to finish off the card. We've got Mint Macaron, Knight of Navy, and Watermelon Wonder. So I'm going to be stamping the sentiment in Knight of Navy. And this one says, "You make me ridiculously happy." And I'm just going to stamp that down here on the lower right hand side. And then I'm going to take the Watermelon Wonder and that tiny little, let me show you here. This tiny little flower right here, I'm going to use that and stamp this in Watermelon Wonder, and I'm just going to stamp that right up here in that corner above the sentiment. And then I want to mount this onto the card base using dimensionals, but before I do that, I want to add just a little bit of interest down here. So I'm taking one of our tea lace doilies and I'm just going to cut this in half, and now I'll be able to use save this one for another project. So I'm just going to be mounting that like so. So let me go ahead and put some snail down here. And what I like to do is to use my grid lines. So I'm going to line this up straight along one of the lines. Get up here a little bit higher. And then I will just, I guess I want about that much to show. So that ensures that it's straight across in the back. And then let's go ahead and mount this up on dimensionals. All right, let's bring our card base back in. And that's just gonna go like so. And then are you like me and just have washi tape rolls just out the yin yang? I've been doing this recently and I like it because I'm using up my washi tape, but it's just kind of a fun technique. You know, we used to have that really cute banner punch, the little tiny one, but we got rid of it, unfortunately. So I wanted to do something similar to that. So I'm using washi tape, and I've been doing this technique. I did this on iStampin' Live earlier this week. And so what I do is I just fold the washi tape in half. Okay, so like that. Okay, and then I'm just gonna trim off the bottom where it's straight across. And I think that looks like good. And then I'm just gonna notch the end. So I cut up in the middle, and then I just go from corner to corner up to where I notched it in the middle, and that will make a cute little banner. Isn't that adorable? All right, and I'm going to attach it right here. And I'm just going to use some snail for this. Well, how about I do it this way? With that washi tape, it kind of resists adhesive, so you have to put the adhesive on the paper for it to stick, or at least that's what I'm experiencing. And then I'm going to use our baker's twine, just our regular Whisper White baker's twine, and I'm going to make a knot, or make a bow. So normally I would use a glue dot to put this bow on, but like I said, with the washi tape, it kind of resists adhesive. So I'm just putting just a little bit of glue from our fine tip glue pen on there, and then I'll put the bow on like that. But the thing about this is that it's kind of slippery, so you'll just want to put a couple of adhesive blocks on top of there. You know, let it sit up for a couple of minutes, you know, maybe no more than 5 minutes, and then it should be good and we'll be able to cut the tails. Okay, so while that is drying, let's go ahead and decorate our envelope. And this is just really easy. So let's get our Watermelon Wonder. And then I am using the smaller flower right here. So I'm gonna use this image, this one, and the leaf. So first we're gonna ink this up in Watermelon Wonder. And I'm just gonna put that right down here in the left bottom corner. Next, let's get our Knight of Navy. I'm going to use that little center image. Just like that. And just decorating an envelope like this, just a little something, it just adds it, and it just makes it so special when that person gets their card in the mail. Okay, and then the little leaf, I'm inking that up in Mint Macaron, and that will just go right about there. And then I want to color in that center part of the flower, and so I'm just going to use my Stampin' Write marker. This is in Daffodil Delight, so this is one of our, this is in our Brights collection. You can find that in our annual catalog and under the Brights section. And I'm just, because I don't want the Knight of Navy to bleed, I'm just really gently just kind of just like just making like little tiny dots all in the center of this flower just to give it some color. And I can get a little bit closer so you can see that. So just, you don't have to do anything like super fancy. Just give it some color. Like I said, you don't want to color really hard because you can smear that ink. And then that's it for the envelope. Let's see if the card, the bow is ready to trim the tails. And then our cute little card will be ready. And then we can finish off the box and our little gift set will be all done. So if you wanted to make, you know, like half a dozen, or not half a dozen, but a dozen of these, and be able to give these as a gift, just really, really cute. So there's our card, and here's our matching envelope. So we're doing a white envelope. Even though we did a crumb cake card base, it can still go into a white envelope. And unfortunately, our crumb cake envelopes have sold out. They're retiring, and they went ahead and sold out. So just super, super, super cute. All right, so let's bring in our box. And I went ahead and I've done quite a bit of the prep work for us just to save time. So I am using the Cheerful Tags, which goes with the Everyday Tags stamp sets, which you can find in our Occasions catalog. So I've already gone ahead and done quite a bit of the prep work. I die cut this out in Whisper White. And I just, so what I did is I die cut this out, obviously, in Whisper White. And then I just got one of the coordinating patterns. And I just ran this through the Big Shot, but I only placed the paper in this section. So then it will just match there perfectly. So it's already has the rounded corners and everything. So I am going to use the You'll Thank Me Later stamp. And I've got that already mounted up, and I'm just going to ink that up in Knight of Navy. And this center part of the stamp, you just want to make sure you get really good coverage. If you need to twist your stamp around, you can do that. And then I'm just going to come right here. Just come right there in the middle. Oops. Ah. Well, I smeared it when I lifted it up like that. I didn't mean to. So just try not to do that. That stinks. All right, so what I decided to do next is I wanted to put something around the box. Oh, so here, let me, before I do that. So then what you would do next is, what I'm envisioning is, you know, you having, you know, 10 of these, 12 of these, how many you'd like, and then just bundle those up with a really cute ribbon and see how nicely they fit in there. Just really perfect. And then you'll put the lid on. And like I was saying, I was wanting to do something. I wanted to tie something around the box, but I didn't necessarily want ribbon. So I thought our Cucumber Crush thick baker's twine was perfect for this. So I am just getting enough out so that I can wrap this around twice. I think that will be good. You want to leave it long enough for you to be able to tie a bow. So I never really know if I'm doing this right. So it's kind of, just have to kind of fiddle around with it to make sure that I have about the same length. Okay, that looks good. All right, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna feed both ends through the tag. And before you did this, I would recommend writing in the tag whatever you wanted to say before you do this part. And because this baker's twine is a little bit thicker, you may need a little bit of guidance to get it through there. So as you can just see, I just used the tip of my scissors. And then from here, you're just going to tie a simple bow. And I like this twine because you can, when I pull it tight, it stays put, and so then I can make a nice bow without having to, you know, without the knot loosening up and all that kind of jazz. And you can just play around with that. And I just think that color is just so pretty. Just plays off so pretty off of the Knight of Navy. And then you'll just come in here and just cut your tails to the desired length. And there you have it. So here's the two boxes, and of course our cards are on the inside. I'll have to take them out of the box so I can photograph them for you. But anyway, I really hope you liked today's tutorial. These boxes, you can use these boxes for so many different things. This is just a great size. Give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can find all the details about the products that I used along with the PDF on how to make the box as well as the card on my blog, which is istampin.com. Please share this with your friends and family on YouTube and Facebook. I'd love for you to join me over on my Facebook group. It's iStampin. And I think that's it. All right, guys, have a great day. Bye.